Hey guys, Stealth here, back with From the Depths, and we're going to try yet another adventure. I have a different plan for this adventure mode, though. Considering that my ships usually get shot at, and they get shot at a lot, I'm going to go airborne. I'm just going to take off and hopefully not get hit as I am airborne. So I'm going to build out a platform, and we're just going to throw on some balloons, and just have it airborne. Hopefully, that is going to make sure that I don't drift out of the zone. And with enough airborne capability, so with enough buoyancy, I should be able to stay quite safe inside the zone, where most surface combatants that don't have any capability of engaging air threats will not be able to target me. Now let's actually get these out of the way. There. And we're airborne. I have found that balloons ascend rather nicely. But, as you can see, my problem here is that I'm not exactly vertical. And this is going to be fixed by trying to balance out the weight. Which won't be easy. But it can be done. Let's throw in the cylinders, get a carburetor going, and let's see about the cooling. Always an important element. What am I missing? Radiators. Like that. 538, looking good. Resources, material storage, large storage. Actually, no, we're going to go with we're going to go with large. Doesn't matter. I'm just going to expand the platform a bit. Throw on a couple of large material storages. And now the bow is dipping again. Is that even the front? No, that's the front. Whatever. Throw in some material gatherers. 1, 2, 3. And my buoyancy is so damn high on the bow that my craft just isn't level enough. So I need to find something that's going to make this front section heavier. It's not a very elegant solution, adding a lead block. But it will work. There we go. Resources are coming in. Provided that I add some fuel. Wait, what? These things can go without energy? Maybe at a very, very slow pace. Resources, fuel storage. Give me a couple of smaller fuel tanks. And place those more or less on the center of mass. There we go. Resources coming in. One over there. Running at 100% power. 16 power left. It's not too much, but it's enough. Let's try and balance it out. And now we're flipping forwards again. I found it to be quite difficult in balancing out airships. It just takes a lot of work. It is doable, but you gotta keep a constant eye on your center of mass. Now, what happens when I get hit is a completely different issue. That is going to be quite a problem. So I gotta try and make sure I don't get hit. Throw in some more cylinders, throw in the coolers, and throw in yet more resource gatherers. Let's see about this. I'm trying to harvest as fast as possible. Let's reinforce these beams. Because if those get blown off by whatever impact they might get, that's the end of the buoyancy on that part of the airship. Not good. And finally, a couple more there. Okay. This is looking a bit better. Now I should be able to throw in a couple more there. And there. Okay. Next order of business. Weapon systems. Let's throw off this lead block. Center of mass is perfectly aligned in the middle. You see that? Altitude, 163. I want more altitude. The higher we go, the more difficult we will be to hit. Now, I can deploy these things manually. That will cause this thing to tilt for a moment, but that's okay. Come on! Look at this. Yep. We're slowly... No, we're not actually ascending as much as I'd hoped. Okay, whatever. Weapon systems. New object. Two-axis turret. I want to have this thing turn airborne as well. And... what am I going to turn this into? I'm going to turn it into a missile battery, that's for sure. I'm going to turn it into a large missile battery. At that. I want to have a lot of launchers. 8 should do. Let's go for 10. Now, this is going to be an expensive piece of weaponry. And that's okay. Let's go for 4 missile length. That just took all of my supplies. These are now too expensive at 100, but there we go. Come on. Yep, done. Okay. Missile type. Short-range thruster, 2 fuel tanks, 2 fins, target prediction guidance, explosive warhead, and an infrared seeker. Looks good. But I might be able to go with laser. For that, I can go with a connector. That is, if I'm editing the hull. Connector. No, connector. 1. Let's make sure this is in mirror mode. We're going to go with laser emitters. Laser-guided missiles tend not to be fooled as easily as the infrared missiles. So let's tell these things that they're actually going to be looking for laser beams. And I want to be looking at this vehicle lasers only. Let's make sure we apply that to all of them. Again, expand on the missile battery. Longer missiles aren't better per se, but they can use additional warheads. Let's go with explosive and 1 fragmentation in a 45 degree cone. Yes, even that can be edited. And this means that the frag elements, those 50 razor sharp fragments, are going to be forward fired in a cone of 45 degrees. Now, this is wonderful, but I need to make sure that these don't all fire at the same time. And I want to have an IFF. Identification, friend or foe. Stops heat-seeking sonar and radar active, or active radar missiles. Actually, considering that this is a laser-guided battery, that shouldn't be a problem. But I do want to have staggered fire add-ons. There. Now there is 2 seconds between each missile launching. Okay. Takes care of that. So the missile is ready to fire, but we don't have an AI that can actually shoot yet. So let's go with the connector. I'm gonna attach a radar upside down, and I'm gonna go for a couple of cameras. One there and one there, so that I can get an active feed on the target. Finally, a receiver. And now we need to build an actual AI. Because that's what you do. Build a mainframe. And we're going to tell that mainframe to start transmitting. This is going to be my, let's say my main, because I don't know yet if I'm going to be building more than one AI. Detection equipment is good. Card slots. I need a few of those. 1, 2. Oh, I do have fuel tanks. Oh, right. Never mind. Thinking of a different build. Target prioritization. And aim point. I want to make sure that stuff that gets close is going to get prioritized. So everything that's close is going to get hit first. And then we're going to get some general processing cards, otherwise the AI might not be able to process all the signals. Detectors need 4.5. It has 4, so I need actually to build another one. There we go. That should do. I have 6 units of general processing power. And 2 of which are trackers. I need 4.5. Done. Good. Next element is going to be a flare system. Missiles are the bane of an airship. Because if you get shot down, you are so bloody screwed. So in order to do that, I'm going to go with a very, very simple system that I found to be quite effective. One that way, one that way, and one this way. Add some gantries. 1, 1, and 1. Missile body is going to be... where are you? Sticky flare. These mean that the missiles are going to be attracted to those things. Then, all you need to do is add a local weapons controller, and you need to attach that to the mainframe, like that. I want to have a maximum fire rate of, let's say, if I tell this to have a maximum fire rate of 0.1 per second, that means that every 10 seconds it's going to fire a flare. That's a bit low. Let's go for every 0.25. And because these things don't actually have any kind of launch mechanism, I need to throw in some... here we are. The ejector add-on. One like that. One like that. You're gonna need one. One there. And I can put one there. Now, watch this. I'm at the bottom end. Here we go. Poof! And it attaches to my own vehicle. That's not good. We need to get a bit of an ejection delay or an ejection adjustment. Ah, oh, crap, I don't have any resources yet. Ammo storage. 1, 2. There we go, rearmed. Test it again. There we go, now it's firing off at an angle. That's better. That was minus 45. Means that you are going to have to be on a 45 degree angle. Try it again. Flare, flare, and flare. Good. So this thing will now fire. This means that my flares are ready to go. Okay, so I can engage ground targets, I can engage air targets. What else would I be needing? What do you mean it's not connected? It doesn't need to be connected, does it? Let me check that. My vehicle missiles only. Controller missiles from this vehicle. Do I need to get a missile controller on each and every section? Really? Looks like. I wonder if this works. I really wonder if this works. Let's go with the transmitter? Maybe? Yeah, no, I don't think that's how it works. Okay, I'm going to abandon this whole idea. I am going to use missiles with lasers. But I'm going to do it on my own way. Now, I hope that all of this noise from outside isn't actually registering on the video. Get me adjusting on this thing. Laser emitter. There. Controlling missiles from its own controller. Perfect. Go do that. And I need to throw in an AI weapons controller. Otherwise, this whole thing won't even work. Give me a wireless receiver, like that. Okay. We're still generating quite a nice amount of resources. So I'm going to start doubling up. I want to make this into a double block ship. There, there. Next. Of course the thing will start to dip. At least a little bit. Not sure if you were able to hear that, but I had to pause the video for a minute to just close the door and shut out all the noise. Okay, airship level. Now let's make sure it's actually well defended against impact, because I will get hit. I will get hit. Unless I make this missile battery even bigger. And by doing so, my hope is that I can take care of the enemy threat. Oh, talking of which, looks like there's a threat out there. Can I detect it? It's not tracking anything. Now, if I add additional fuel tanks to this missile system, hopefully, my missiles are going to have so much range that I can shoot down anything that might come close before it's going to be a problem. So we're going to go with a short range, with another fuel tank. I already have plenty of warheads. We need to have another laser beam designator. Actually, I can go with a laser beam receiver and an active radar. There. Not sure what the range is on these things. Can I control them manually, please? There's the laser. I thought I saw a target somewhere. Somewhere on the horizon. Where are you? Not seeing ghosts, am I? Where is that bloody target? Now, the way that I have this thing set up at the moment means that it is going to follow the laser and another designator or another system, so possibly the laser is going to get out of range. If it does... Oh crap, I just ran out of fuel. If it does, then that's okay. Because then the active radar warhead, or the radar receiver, is going to take over. That thing, the active radar seeker. Where are the targets? Alright, let's quickly build this thing into a sort of a mini box for my character. Let's go with lightweight alloy. Weight is 5, weight is 10. I don't really need to be out on the wings that often, so I can basically start closing this thing off. Get the weapons, especially this stuff has to be inside. I'm going to need quite a few of those as well. Missiles are generally quite expensive. Especially the longer they get. The longer they get, the more expensive they get. The more expensive they get, the more ammo crates you will need. And unfortunately, my flare ejector system is over there. But that's workable. There, up like that. Okay. Still not seeing any targets. Still a good thing. And I'm gonna make it... What would happen if I would start using jet stabilizers to try and keep this thing level? One and two. Yeah, that doesn't do anything. Cancel those. If I have to run, I want to be able to run. That's the bow of the ship. So we're going to go with a couple of jet engines. Which might be weird on a Zeppelin, but whatever. One there. I'm going to go with a couple down here. You never know. A And this will mean that I need some sort of control center. For which I won't really be needing two of those. Let's get the Hearthstone back. Control. Thrust controller. No, vehicle controller. There, take it out of naval mode. Thrusters engaged. Now, for some reason, this thing will need a sort of tailplane. Otherwise, it won't even allow me control of the other elements. It's a bit weird, but whatever. So now I should be able... Yay, we can turn. Good thing. We're still very heavy on the bow. I can push it back up. The problem is that the balloons just don't have enough buoyancy. I'm just not light enough on the bow. There's just so much stuff there. Now I'm considering taking out this vehicle for a spin. Here's a thought. How about adding wings? This is going to be a really unusual craft. Let's just put it like that. Because my thing is going to get wings, which should make it a bit more fuel efficient, I'm thinking. Let's take a line here, like that. Tell the game to fill it up. And same over here. Fill it up. We're gonna add ailerons. I have no idea if this is going to work, so this is very experimental. Same with the ailerons, I don't even know if it's handy to have two layers or not. It's on the right side, it's on the left side. Okay. So that should do. Now what I want to go and do is build more missile systems, but in a slightly different way than normal. These are going to be downward facing. I'm basically going to turn them into a sort of, I'm not really sure, maybe a mine layer? Something along those lines. They just have to be two blocks. That's all that I need. A couple like that. Then add a connector. Add staggered fire add-ons. Ah, oh, crap, they're not even connected. I need connectors first. All there, and all there. New controller. Now I can actually control the type, and staggered fire add-ons. See, the thing with an airship is that it's great, but the problem is that it simply doesn't have the capacity to get a gun. Unless you get a ton of recoil stabilizers on that gun. I'm going to turn this into a mine, which means I'm going to give it a regulator so it can stay alive a little longer. It won't need anything along the lines of fuel. I'm going to throw in a magnet and a couple of explosive warheads, and that's it. Apply. So that was regulator, magnet, explosives. Wait for it. Regulator... magnets. Oh, it looks like my battery is engaging something. Explosive warheads. Apply to wall. What do we get? Multiple targets have spawned in. There's one. There's two. Looks like my missiles are going all over the fucking place. Although... they might actually be going into a useful direction. It looks like they're first being sent by the laser, and then they get the radar guidance. I hope that it works. Now, although the range with the additional fuel tank is slightly better, I'm still going to say that it should have a maximum range of about 1500, like that. I have no idea if it works. What are my missiles doing? Where are they going? Oh yeah, they're definitely hitting something. Look at that! Wrecker no more. That thing just got completely destroyed by my missiles. It's too heavily damaged, and there's 1600 supplies down there. Yes, please. Where do I sign up? I need to get over there somehow. All right, we're gonna go with control systems. I need a control terminal. And I want that right over here. Wireless cam. Multiple targets engaging. There's the flares going out. I'm absorbing some of the damage that I have been doing to the enemy aircraft. Whoa, 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 we're taking fire. What the hell? This thing has an IFF, right? Yeah, no, it doesn't. This thing is detecting my ship as an actual threat. Don't do that. Now, those balloons will get recycled at some point. Let's go with a couple of repair bots. Come on, quick, quick, quick. Need to stay airborne. It'd be nice if we could do so right about now. Also, because of my terrible angle, I'm no longer gaining resources. Could you deploy, please? And we're stable-ish. Looks like there's something else out there. Where? Yep, there's definitely something coming in. A Vanguard retrofit worth 4,800 materials. If I can toast that thing, that would be wonderful. I don't have enough to get those missiles back up. Let's go with a couple of resource systems, ammunition processors. Now, whereas my ammo blocks are generating ammo themselves, these are going to do so faster. So that I can get more missiles on target faster. Let's see, are they hitting yet? Where's that craft? Looks like they're still going towards the target. There's one. No, it runs out of fuel before it gets there. Okay, that explains that. Still haven't actually added a weapons controller to this stuff. Let's do so before I forget it. Local weapon controller, mirror mode. Over there. And first off, maximum altitude to engage is 5 meters. This is a mine. It's not supposed to be an airborne target. Like that. No! Guys, there's nothing out there. Oh, actually, there is. My bad. Maximum range to engage. So that thing is at 1900 meters. Okay. Minimum range? No limit. Maximum range? Let's say 100. Although that's. No, 50. This is basically an overhead drop. Same for you. Maximum range to engage? 50. Come on. Be a bitch about it. 50, maximum altitude. 5. It's right below. Oh, we're hit! We're hit! We're hit! What the hell is this missile system working on? Get a grip, man. Start targeting the actual bad guys. Come on. That one, for example. No, 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 not the flyer. My AI mainframe is going after the wrong targets. Set value per altitude to maximum. I need this thing to target the. I'm not even sure what it is. Ooh, we're taking fire. That thing looks like it's flying in a really weird pattern, but it is doing significant damage to my ship. There it goes. It's firing infrareds. My flares are deterring those missiles. Look at that. Not all of them, though. Not all of them. Come on! Whoa, all of my balloons are dead. Do we still have a balloon switcher? I don't think so. Air? Hot air deployer switch. Come on! Edit the hull. Be one of these things. Deploy. Oop, that was cut. Deploy! No! No! What the hell? That's 6 of my 8 balloons going up. And we're airborne. Ish. I wouldn't call us exactly stable. Let me edit these missiles. We're gonna go for infrared. Apply to all. Some of these missiles are doing some really weird shit. Where are the targets? I thought I was being attacked, but all of a sudden, they're gone? Tell me how that works. Because I sure as hell didn't kill them. So where are they? There's one. That's the mule. Quite expensive. Curious. My health is going back up. Wings are being reconstructed. This balloon needs to deploy. The other balloon is still being built. Or repaired, rather. What are these missiles up to, though? Definitely engaging something. I'm not really too sure what. I don't like this laser beam receiver. We're going to switch that out for a camera. Tell it to not engage the heat part, but to engage a specific random or a particular random block. It doesn't matter what it hits. But what this does is that when your craft has managed to kill off an enemy engine, what you want it to do is go after something else. You want it to go after, let's say, weapon systems. And by doing so, you're whoa! What's going on? They knocked out my Hearthstone. Not good. Can I get a reserve one? I can only get one. Well, that's problematic. Okay. Can I deploy that second air balloon? Whoa, the game's a bit slow-ish. I did 200 damage to something. No idea what, though. There's something out. Where is it? No idea. Alright, well, I'm going to stop the episode here. This seems like a decent enough moment as any. I have a decent ship going. It's still popping missiles and flares all over the place. The missiles are not actually doing anything, and neither are the flares. So, let's hope that I can keep this ship airborne, build it out further, keep digging, keep going, and just keep expanding. And most of all, stay alive. But more on that next episode. For now, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you soon for more From the Depths. Hey guys, Stealth here. Welcome back to From the Depths. My airship is still airborne. My missiles are still popping all over the place, and I have been... No! What the hell? Oh, this is terrible. Something hit me. And I'm screwed. There is no way for me to get back up. Oh, yeah, right. This had to happen to me. Oh my god. Really? Really. So, this was supposed to be a second video. This was supposed to be... this was supposed to be a new series. What in fact happened is that I dropped off of my craft and died. The end. I think that the idea is valid. I think that the bottom of the craft was not good enough, and I think that my missile system needs work. So I'm going to go back to the drawing board, experiment some more with From the Depths, and get back to you soon with another try of either the airship or a ground ship, we'll see. For now, let me know what your thoughts are. it's quite embarrassing that I just dropped down, but we'll see. Happens. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. See you soon for more naval warfare. I can't even get that right. For more From the Depths. See you soon, guys.